you ever get complaints in your line of work? Do you ever get someone saying, oh, I want my money back, it wasn't what I thought it was going to be?
No, I tell you what, I had a very, very miserable guy in the front row at a gig in Inverness, not this tour, but the previous tour, and a guy who'd obviously been dragged there by his son and doesn't like comedy and was sitting in the front row. And he was one of those people who, not only was he not laughing, he was looking at other people funny for laughing.
Like glowering.
Just miserable from the word go. And I just say, if I gave you your money back, will you just go? I didn't say it as politely as that.
Right, right.
And he said yes. And I gave him his 20 quid and I said, go. Not as politely as that. That's the only refund I've given. But even then, it was only because I could see it.
Yeah, yeah.
I felt like, I mean, and it was a great gig. I think that was the reason why I did it, because I was enjoying the gig so much, but I kept looking down at this pure misery just looking back at me.
Tormenting you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not having it. Git.
You had someone faint at your gig the other day, sorry.
I have had four people faint at the gig.
Congratulations.
Now.
Is that some kind of record?
I think so. I've had two people in Brighton, one person in Leicester, and one person in Cheltenham now.
So have
now
you looked at the data and seen a correlation between any of these?
I haven't. I've been trying to figure out what all those towns have in common, and I can't find a common factor, really. But it's always at the same point. There's a bit in the show where I talk about how I had a hernia operation. But it's not, like, really graphic. I'm not talking about suction and... You know, it's generally, I think it's when I talk about the anaesthetist and she puts a needle in my arm.
Yeah, yeah.
But again, I don't describe in graphic detail my veins. But anyway, yeah, I'm going to describe in graphic detail now. But,
well, maybe we've got a load of listeners fainting at this moment.
Yeah, I have to be careful with
that. Like, what's driving?
But four people.
That's astonishing.
And all middle-aged men.
That's astonishing.
Isn't it?
Yeah, I won't bore you with the story, but I once had a thing where I'd had a medical procedure. A friend of mine was out of the country at the time. We were in a restaurant. I was describing it to him, and he fainted there and then. And it was to do with a lumbar puncture, you know, where you get a needle right in your spine. So there must be a syndrome. Maybe they could name it after you, because I don't think I've heard it called something before. Ed Byrne syndrome.
Well, I don't know. I think Byrne has already kind of been taken by medical.
Yeah.
they have units that are just dedicated to Byrnes. So I don't think, I think it'd confuse people if it also became the name of the syndrome for people scared of needles.